Hi everyone, Steve Patterson here from Photoshop Essentials. In this video, I show you where to find the missing gradients, patterns, and shapes in Photoshop. Back in Photoshop 2020, Adobe replaced the gradients, patterns, and shapes that had been part of Photoshop for years with brand new ones. And it looks like the new ones are now all we have. But the old ones are not gone, they're just hidden. They're now called legacy gradients, patterns, and shapes, and in this video, I show you where to find them. I also show you where to find new patterns and hundreds of new shapes that were added in 2020 but are hidden by default. So when we're done, you'll have access to every gradient, pattern, and shape that's included with Photoshop. I'm using Photoshop 2021, but these steps should apply to any version from 2020 and up. Let's get started. To load more gradients, patterns, or shapes, you don't need to have an image or a document open, but you do need to be in Photoshop's main interface rather than on the home screen. So if you're on the home screen, like I am here, click the Photoshop icon in the top left corner. And now we're in the main workspace with the panels along the right. We'll need some of these panels to load our gradients, patterns, and shapes. We'll start by loading Photoshop's missing gradients. Open the Gradients panel. It's in the same panel group as the Color, Swatches, and Patterns panels. If you're not seeing the Gradients panel, you can open it by going up to the Window menu in the menu bar and choosing Gradients. Now all of the new gradients from Photoshop 2020 are loaded by default, and they're divided into groups based on theme. So we have blues, purples, pinks, and so on. You can scroll through them using the scroll bar along the right, or you can resize the panel to view more groups at once. To open a group and view the gradients inside it, click the arrow next to its folder. You can resize the thumbnails by clicking the panel's menu icon and choosing a new size from the menu. And to close a group, click again on the arrow. Before we load more gradients, here's a quick tip. If you press and hold the Control key on a Windows PC or the Command key on a Mac and open a group, you'll open every group at once. You can then scroll through the thumbnails to view the gradients. Hold Control or Command again while closing a group to close them all. So what's missing from the Gradients panel are all of the classic or legacy gradients from earlier Photoshop versions. To load them, click the panel's menu icon and choose Legacy Gradients. A new Legacy Gradients group appears below the others. And if you twirl the group open and scroll down, you'll find all of Photoshop's gradients from the past. The first group at the top holds the classic default gradients, and below it are different gradient sets that could be loaded in separately. If you press and hold the Control or Command key while opening a legacy group, you'll open them all at once, so you can scroll through the thumbnails. Then hold Control or Command again to close them. And that's how to load the missing gradients in Photoshop. Next, we'll load the missing patterns. Open the Patterns panel, which is found beside the Gradients panel. If you're not seeing it, go up to the Window menu and choose Patterns. Now, unlike Gradients, where the only ones missing are from older Photoshop versions, the Patterns panel is missing the legacy patterns plus most of the new patterns from Photoshop 2020. In fact, by default, only 3 of the new pattern groups are listed. Open a group to view the patterns inside it, or change the thumbnail size from the panel's menu. And click the arrow again to close the group. Now I'll be covering how to apply gradients and patterns and how to draw shapes in separate videos. To load the missing patterns, click the Patterns panel menu icon and choose Legacy Patterns and More. Then twirl open the new Legacy Patterns and More folder, and inside are 2 more folders, 2019 Patterns and Legacy Patterns. The 2019 Patterns folder holds more new patterns from Photoshop 2020. And that's because Photoshop 2020 was actually released near the end of 2019. Again, if you press and hold the Control key on a Windows PC or the Command key on a Mac while opening a group, you'll open them all at once. Then hold Control or Command again to close them. And the Legacy Patterns folder holds all of the patterns from earlier Photoshop versions, including the old default patterns, plus the additional pattern sets. If I open them all at once, we see that there's lots to choose from. And that's how to load the missing patterns. Let's finish up by loading Photoshop's missing shapes. And there are lots of shapes missing, including the legacy shapes plus hundreds of new shapes from 2020. To load them, we need the Shapes panel. But unlike Gradients and Patterns, the Shapes panel is not part of Photoshop's default workspace. To open it, go up to the Window menu and choose Shapes. The Shapes panel opens in the secondary column to the left of the main panels, and you can show and hide the panel by clicking its icon. Only a few of the shapes are listed by default, and all of them are new from 2020. Open a group to view the shapes, or change the thumbnail size from the panel menu. I'd recommend using small thumbnails because you're about to have a lot more shapes to choose from. To load the missing shapes, click again on the Shapes panel menu icon and choose Legacy Shapes and More. I'll make my Shapes panel longer so we can see more shapes at once. Then twirl open the Legacy Shapes and More folder, and inside are folders for the 2019 shapes and the Legacy Shapes. 2019 Shapes is where you'll find hundreds more shapes that were all added in Photoshop 2020. We have spiral shapes and people shapes, and there's different types of animals to choose from, and even dinosaurs, plus different types of games and more. Again, these were all added in Photoshop 2020. And finally, the All Legacy Default Shapes folder holds all of the classic shapes from previous versions, including the old default shapes at the top. And there we have it! You now have access to every gradient, pattern, and shape in Photoshop. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you found it helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Visit my website, PhotoshopEssentials.com, where you'll find hundreds of Photoshop tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.